you guys, I'm gonna install this Honeywell digital doorknob. That's for exterior entry, but I'm gonna try and use it for interior. Here's the knob that I'll be replacing. So I'm gonna take this one all the way off. So in this box here, there's these two boxes. So this is where the handle's at. Okay, in the bigger box, that's what this was in. See, it says this side against the door, so it's going to go through that hole. Alright, that's going to go through. Now I'm going to take these two silver screws, and they're going to go through there, and they're going to screw in. Makes sense, you don't want to mount this thing first before these two screws, because this could move around just a little bit. It might be off just a tad. Let's screw these in all the way. Now you take this piece, connect that right there. Okay, you got that snapped in there. Next thing you want to do is put two screws right in there. The holes lined up. There's the two screws right there. Come on the back. Got one in. There's the second one. Well, guess what? If you lock it, nothing happens on the outside. So lock. Unlock it. Now it'll engage that, so locked. Locked, just twist. That's nice. It's locked right now. Keep it unlocked. Let's go ahead and set the code. Okay, so there's different codes. So it comes preset with a programming code, 12356, and a user code of 1234. Now, after we get this installed, we're going to change those and the user code as well. Okay, to test this thing out, we're going to press the lock button and then 1234 to unlock. So we'll press lock and then we'll press 1234 to unlock. Okay, so lock. It's supposed to lock it. Oh, it did it. See? Unlock it, and we'll go unlock, 1, 2, 3, 4. Unlock. Okay, so you go 1, 2, 3, 4, then unlock. Oh, I engaged it. Alright, lock. So you go, just, okay, just to lock it, you just push the lock button. To unlock, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, unlock. That's it. Lock it. Unlock. 1, 2, 3, 4. Unlock. Here we go. That's how you do it. Alright, this thing comes with directions on how to change your preset programming code and then also the user code. So you just follow this sequence here for the programming code to change, and then you follow this sequence here for your user code.